Now that we have the nodes placed, which are the inlets, or the flared in sections, or the manholes, those drainage structures, once those are placed, now we can use the Place Conduit tool to place the pipe in between each one of those nodes. To get to the Place Node tool, we will go to the Layout tab and then go to the Place Conduit. Now inside of here, you got some different options that you can look at depending on how you want to place it. What we're going to do is change our feature definition to the type of conduit that you want. So if you click on the down arrow, you're going to see underneath this drainage, actually conduit, stormwater, drainage, you're going to see channels and pipes. For this example, we're going to do pipes. After that, you determine what type of pipe that you want to place. For this example, just to kind of show you how the conduit tool works, we're going to select this one that says circular concrete, which is basically going to be a concrete pipe that ties in between each one of these inlets and also the flared in section. So I will select it. Then you have to give it a description, which is basically what size do you want the pipe to be. So I will click on my down arrow, and now you're going to see all the available pipes that are out there. And this is being pulled from the conduit catalog that is set up by default. That's where it's pulling that information from. So I will go down through here and I'm going to select, for this example, a 12-inch pipe. Now it's simply going through there and selecting your start point and then your end point. Now, what you want to do whenever you're placing the pipes is to place it in the direction of flow that you think the water is going to flow. So like for this one right here, I know this one here is in a sag situation, and then the water is going to go down to this flared in section right here. As we scroll through here, I'm going to select it at this inlet. Now you'll notice as I move my mouse around, you're going to see some points that are out there with a plus beside it. Basically, those are the connection points that are available for that particular node. And you'll see that being different for different inlets and also manholes. So I'm going to select one of those connection points, which I'm going to select this one right here. And now as I move my mouse out, you'll see that it's being tied to that beginning point. And now I will go down to my flared in section. And on flared in section, it just has one connection point. So once I see that orange plus, I can go ahead and left click to accept it. And now it has that pipe in between there. And since I have my 3D turned off, it just shows me a line going from point A to point B. So those two are connected. I can do the same thing for this one right here. I know the direction of flow is going in this direction, going from left to right. So I will tie it to this point right here. And as I scroll down through here, I'm going to go to my sag inlet, which is at station 3+00. And I'm going to tie it at this point right here. Left click to accept it. And I'm good to go. And then now I'll do the same thing from station 1 to station 2. Go from there, and I will go to there. And now we have the conduit placed in between each one of those. And then once I'm done with it, I'll hit the F4 key to clear it out. So now that I have my pipes in there, just to make sure that it has the 3D portion of it tied to it also, I will go back to my Home tab, go to Attachment Tools, and turn on my drainage, and you'll see that it actually has the actual pipe assigned to it. Another way that I can do it, which is probably a little bit better way, is if I hit the F6 key, and in my view number 2, I can go through here and I can look at those pipes. Now, I'm going to go back to my Home tab and turn off my corridor, and now if I do a Fit View, we can see the pipes that are attached to each one of those inlets. And you can kind of review that accordingly, depending on the situation that you got. So you can kind of see your stormwater drainage network kind of has taken shape now. Now another neat little thing with this, which doesn't really pertain to drainage, but if I go back to my top view, and I will do a fit view, if I go back to my attachment tools, you notice that I had my corridor turned on, but then also I can see through my corridor right now because I have it set to 50%, which is a transparency. And if that's not turned on, you can simply right click up above here and turn on this option that says transparency if you don't see that particular column. And with the transparency, what you can do is actually see through that particular reference file that's out there. You can apply a transparency to it. So like this one here, I want to apply it. Let's say I want to put in a 70% transparency. So basically I can see through that now and kind of see what's going on with my network. So now if I zoom in and we'll say we go to this first node right here, and I come in here and I use my rotate tools, and I will grab that plus and just snap to that inlet. You can kind of rotate that around and kind of see through that particular reference file, which may be beneficial if you're looking at how everything's laying out and make sure it's set in the right locations according to your corridor that you have. Now, after you've applied that transparency, if for some reason that transparency does not get applied, simply go to your view attributes, making sure that you have view number 2 highlighted. If you go to your view attributes, make sure that you have this transparency option toggled on. It may not show up the first time, so you may have to go in here and simply toggle that on to apply the transparency. So that's how to use the Place Conduit tool in OpenRoads Designer. Simply, once you have the nodes placed, you can go in there and use the Place Node tool, use whichever option that you want to connect to each one of those nodes that are placed out there.